Like, real shit, I was on the way to my boss's house, like, masked up, like, ready to go. And then I realized that the police are still funded, so. Next year. That is some crazy stuff. Like, how is the government, like, out of money? Like, what are the rest of us gonna do? I'm like, holy shit, I do security. Like, I'm barely getting anything as it is. I mean, the FBI is broke, then, like, better start robbing people, like, right now. Starting the night with this club. No, I'm just kidding. We're good. Everyone outside of it, though. Not so much. But yeah, we live in some strange times, man. Strange times. Like, when I was a kid, like, I was growing up watching stuff like Back to the Future and the Jetsons, and I thought we were getting all this cool stuff by now, like flying cars and sneakers that tie themselves and extendo baseball bats and hoverboards, and come to find out we're going into Mad Max and Back to the Future. So I guess I gotta get some leather straps and a fucking Humvee to keep with the times. Jason mask and maybe do some push-ups. Yes, I got this weird figure. Like, you know, chicks are like, hey, so do you work out? And I'm like, I did, and then I stopped. It's like midway through. I was like, the dad bod's a thing, right? I have a few kids so I can make that shit legit. I'm adopting, so anybody knows me, good kids. So we got the craziest president I've like ever seen in my life. I mean, that guy is so entertaining. Like, I can't not like watch what he does. Like, he runs the country like I used to play video games back in the day, if that makes any sense. It's like, hey, we're playing Trade Wars on Nintendo. And then like every time like you start getting hit, he just pulls your remote out. Oh, look at that. I'm winning the game, loser. Like, if I'd have thought about that earlier, I wouldn't have studied theater. I would have studied fucking politics. The fucking whiz at Nintendo. I would have been running the country by now. If only I had known. So, like, yeah, I don't know. Like, there's a shitload of slack on this mic. I feel like Indiana Jones. Speak it up. Someone said that earlier. Super Bowl's coming up. I was excited for it, and then my team, like, ate shit, like, right at the end of the Chicago Bears. That's what we do. And then we sit at home and talk crap about the rest of the teams and how we could have kicked their asses if we didn't suck. But I would love, like, referees to be running around, like, real life scenarios. Like, I kind of feel like people should be timed out or, like, flagged on the plays, certain areas in life. Story time. I was at a club with my friend, my buddy, you know, he's a white guy, but you know, we pal around, like that. Every now and then I take him to the hood, you know, so we can get it in, he can see how we do on our side, but you know, sometimes, you know, they get a little too excited, so, okay, I'm in there, you know, I'm good, I'm with a brother, like, that's my pass, which is cool, you know, we're at the club, we're dancing, we're doing the songs, and he's good, like, he's got it down, he's done the research, he's done the culture, like, that's my boy. But there's certain songs where every now and then you gotta flag a brother on the plate. You know, you gotta hit him for traveling. We're doing the song, and that one song, Whippin' Nene, comes on. And we're like, yeah, watch me. And I was like, oh shit. It's like, I think I just killed my friend. And he's getting down, he's like, watch me, Nene. Now watch me. And I was like, flag on the plate. I was like, break. We're still a little sensitive about the whipping stuff. If you can just keep it to the nay-nay for the rest of the song, that'd be great. That'd be great. Thanks, guys, up there. That's great.
Give it up for Darren! You're welcome to bring three cultural white people. Educate with divine savvy. All right, coming up to the stage next. You know, you love them. You got great hair and big gauges. Give it up for Jesse Calamone! Attraction, he doesn't have the gauges.